Okay, magnetic field produced in a linear current carrying wire. Linear means straight. That wire or conductor is put in straight. So like this. Okay, so this is the rod where the current is flowing. So linear, straight. So we observe the magnetic field around the linear current conductor. Okay, how it will be? So they asked to take material required 6 volt battery, 1 way key switch, rectangular cardboard piece, 1 piece of straight thick copper wire, iron fillings, etc. Iron filling means small like iron powder, like iron things. Take the piece of cardboard, pierce the copper wire vertically through the center of the cardboard, so that the cardboard remains fixed in a flat horizontal position. So here, take a electric conductor and keep it. This is the cardboard taking in the rectangular shape, and inside that they have pierced. Pierced means they have put inside this one, this electric conductor, and this is the copper wire, and this is the battery, and this is the switch and current controller and ammeter. So everything is here. So what to do first? Now switch on current by closing the circuit. Closing the circuit means, so we close all the circuits, positive, negative and everything, and connect everything properly and put on the switch. Then gently tap the cardboard. You will observe that iron fillings arrange themselves in a particular shape, and the compass needle gets deflected in a particular direction. And we saw in the last video, so how the magnetic compass is deflecting. Deflecting means it is changing its direction when the electricity is flowing in the conductor. Okay, so that is the, it will show. So the iron fillings arrange themselves. Now here you see, okay, this is the one. As the iron, some line, this line is far from this, yes. So the magnetic field is depends upon the distance. Okay, if the magnetic compass is near this one, it deflects more. If the magnetic compass is far away from here, it will be deflecting little. That means it will be direction will be changing only the little. So the magnetic field, the magnetic lines depends also on the distance of the magnetic compass. And the second one, it depends upon the current flow. Okay, so now add a current controller and ammeter to the circuit as shown in the figure. Change the amount of current flowing. Now decrease the current flowing in the circuit and observe the effects on the magnetic field by placing the compass at various points on the cardboard. You shall observe that the needle deflection increases in intensity when current flowing in the conductor increases. Okay, underline this point. When the current is increases, the flow of current increases, the deflection of the compass needle is also increases. If the current flow is kept constant but the compass is brought nearer to the conductor, the deflection in the compass needle becomes more pronounced. If the magnetic compass is bringing near to the electric wire conductor, it will be deflecting more. Okay, when we are taking far, it is deflecting less. Okay, so indicating higher field intensity. Higher field intensity means what? The electricity is flowing more, and the magnetic field is also increasing. So the magnetic field depends upon the distance also. You will observe that the distance between the concentric lines of force is shorter near the conductor, and the circles grow farther apart and more dispersed as the distance from the conducting wire increases. Therefore, the magnetic field intensity is inversely proportional to the distance. Inversely proportional means it is not equal.
So, what is... We know that a current-carrying conductor behaves like a magnet. So, what is the pattern of this magnetic field? Let us do an activity to find out the pattern around it. We have taken a straight, thick copper wire connected to an electric circuit to pass current through it. And iron filings in a sprinkler. Sprinkle iron filings around the conductor. Insert the plug key and observe. We can observe that the iron filings are aligning in a pattern of concentric circles. These represent magnetic field lines. Let's place the compass over these lines. The direction of the north pole of the compass represents the direction of these magnetic field lines. By moving the compass over the lines, we can see the direction at each point. By moving the compass away from the conductor, we can see that the deflection of the needle decreases. It indicates that the magnetic field decreases as the distance from it increases. It can be noticed by the larger circles formed away from the conductor. So, we found that a straight conductor carrying current produces concentric magnetic field lines around it.